Hi, this is Chuck Davis from Letterhead Fonts. Today I wanted to talk to you about the carved gold template that I created for Photoshop. This makes it really easy to create three-dimensional gold effects. I've already done all of the work for you, and all you need to do is edit the smart object. So I wanted to show you how easy that is. So let's begin by going to the Letterhead Fonts site and scroll down to the bottom of any of the pages, and you'll see free stuff, okay? And that will take you to this page where you can see all of our free downloads, and download the carved gold template, okay? And this is a PSD file that will work with versions as early as CS6. Okay, and go ahead and download it, and that'll download a zip file. Inside the zip file, you'll find some instructions on what to do with it. So I'm not going to go over that so much, but basically all you need to do is really just open the file. Now, when you first open the file, you'll see the word create. And by default, this uses LHF Chicago script. If you don't have LHF Chicago script, no problem. It will default to another font when you edit it. I recommend choosing a font that is rather simple. That is, one that can show off the light and the dark sides of the bevel effect. If something is too complicated, Photoshop doesn't seem to do as well a job with fonts that are distressed and complicated like that. So I recommend choosing a rather simple font. Script works okay as long as it's thick enough, okay? All right, so what you want to do is begin by double-clicking on the layer that says Edit This Layer. That will open a PSB file. And if it's the first time you're doing this, you may see a dialogue from Photoshop telling you that. Get your text tool and highlight over the text and type your desired message. In this case, we'll type the word gold. Go to File and Save, and then return to the other tab, which is your original PSD file, and you will see that your text appears here in the bevel effect. Now, this is a good time to talk about the highlights layer that I have in the file. You'll notice that we have that spot that was previously left over from the old text. So that doesn't really work in this case, because as you can see, the spot is actually on the dark side of the letter. You have a dark side and you have a lighter side. In other words, the light source is coming from our bottom right side and shining up at the letters. So that would make this spot, this what I call a hot spot, in the wrong area. This is totally incorrect. So you have to take the time to adjust these highlights and put them where they need to be. So this needs to be on the light side of a letter. And typically I would put that at the lightest point of a letter where you could still see and appreciate the effect, okay? So you might put it there, all right? You can see that already that looks better to your eyes. It just looks correct. You could put it here or here. But what you don't want to do is put it here, okay, or there. It's totally incorrect. It needs to be at the light side of the letters. So I think I've drilled that home enough. Now, let me show you. I've created four different types of highlights for you. All right, this happens to be number two. If we look at number one, that's a different effect. It has more of a horizontal ray of light, and you can move that there. And we'll look at number three. Number three is more of a diagonal shooting ray of light. And finally, number four, which is more of like reflection on a camera lens. And you can use these together if you're subtle and careful about it. What you don't want to do is use number one, and you put number one here, and number four is over here. Okay, we're going to go ahead and add number two, and we'll put that down here. See, it's just becoming overwhelming, and the effect is totally ruined that way. So use maybe one in per design, okay? That's not to say that you can't overlap them. Check this out. If I turn on number one and I put that here, see? Those two work together. But I guess the way it works best is if your particular hotspot is in one designated area, as if that is the brightest part of the entire design. Like the light was super bright at that particular area. That seems to work the best. So now let me tell you how to edit the bevel effect to get the effect that you want. All right, we'll go ahead and close the highlights layer, and we'll open the edit this layer, and you'll see the different various effects. And go ahead and double click on bevel and emboss, and that will open the layer style palette. All right. If you soften, if you play around with the soften, you'll notice I have it set at zero. If you play around with the soften, it's a totally different effect. Now, that may be what you want. Okay. Maybe you don't want to notice the jagged line the imperfect jagged line that's in the center of the letter. So you can downplay that by softening it a bit. This is probably the most important and dramatic change that you can make, and that is the angle, okay? The direction of the light source. Play around with this and rotate this and move it in towards the dot, and you'll notice how dramatic this changes. You're basically, see now, if I put it here, I can change the light source entirely. Okay. The contour also, the gloss contour that is, changes the effect dramatically. All right. So it's just a matter of playing around with these and getting the effect that you are looking for. Okay, we'll leave it there for now. All right, so I'm going to hit OK. And we'll go ahead and turn this logo off because that's just getting in our way right now. Okay, so now I wanted to show you how to add lighting effects to the letters and actually increase the drama a little bit. All right, so before we do this, I like to affect the entire layer, okay? There may be other ways to do this that doesn't require rasterizing the layer like this, but I prefer to do it this way, okay? So what we're going to do is before we do this, I'm going to close this arrow like this. And I'm going to duplicate this layer, okay? I'm going to turn off my backup, because we don't need it right now. And I'm going to take the time to rasterize layer style, okay? And now this is no longer a smart editable object, okay? But that's okay. That's what I want in this case. So grab your lasso tool and start outside of your letters. Create a diagonal thin mask similar to this shape and feather it by going to Select, Modify, Feather. And this feather radius is going to need to be adjusted depending on the size that you're working at. In this case, I think 20 would be a good choice. Sometimes this is hit and miss and you just got to play around with the number. And now I'm going to go to Image, Adjustments, Exposure. Now watch what happens when I move this exposure up. See, it brightens this area. Now, if you do it too much, then you're just it's overblown and the effect is ruined. So you can also underdo it, which causes the opposite effect. In this case, we want to brighten it a little bit like that. All right, so hit OK when you're happy with it. And then take your mask and move it. Make sure that you're moving it with the lasso tool selected. If you move it with the move tool, while the move tool is selected, you'll actually be moving the pieces of the letter. So you don't want that. You only want to move the mask itself. And we will maybe put it in here. What you want to do is choose an area to brighten. And obviously, you can't brighten an already bright area, so you want to choose maybe a darker area. Okay? Image, Adjustments, Exposure. Okay? Notice that the color is different here. You're bringing out various tones of color also, which make it all that more realistic. I'm going to move this over here. And also experiment with thinner masks. Okay, I'm going to make my mask a little bit thinner here. And I'm going to feather it still. And then go into Image, Adjustments, and Exposure. Okay. Hit OK, maybe right in here. All right. Okay. Now you would only do this if you're happy with your bevel effect, because you can't change your bevel effect at this point. It's a rasterized object that is no longer editable in that way. All right, so that about covers it for this tutorial. If you have any questions about how to use the template or something I neglected to address in this tutorial, feel free to post it in the comments, or you can even email me, okay? Watch for my next video, where I'll show you how to create Chrome effects from this same template. Thanks for watching.